everybody, I am Jedi Jack Penguin, and today I'm bringing you another LEGO Overwatch review. So today I have set number 75970, Tracer vs. Widowmaker. This set contains 129 pieces and retails for $14.99 in the US. So I got this a little bit early at Walmart, but I just finally got around to building this set up. So there will be no speed build within the set since I already built it. So let's take a quick look at the box. So right here we have the main LEGO Overwatch logo, as well as Tracer right there on the side in her minifigure form. We also have a nice little background for this set. This set just looked really interesting when I first saw it. Since that ship does look really cool, though when you build it, it's sort of like, it's interesting some of the features that LEGO put into this set, I guess. We also have the Blizzard logo right there, and we got the back of the box right here, which is a somewhat duplicate to the front of the box, which you also have all the regular information on this side, as well as the names of the characters, Tracer and Widowmaker. You can also open up the set with this little push-in right here, and then we have the LEGO.com/Overwatch on the bottom. We have the top of the box with the LEGO logo, set number, some other miscellaneous information, and the actual sizes of both Tracer and Widowmaker characters right there. Then we have this side of the box with the LEGO Overwatch logo as well as the Overwatch symbol. We have this side of the box with the LEGO logo, and also we have both of the characters' side views right there. We also have Fatal, which I guess, I don't know why they have that written there, but we also have the Choking Hazard right here, and then we finally have the bottom of the box with the LEGO logo, set number, some of the LEGO trademarks, and then the barcode for the set. So that is all for the box. So yeah, let's take a look at the instructions, and then we'll take a look at the overall model. Okay, so here are the instructions that are included within the set. We also get a sticker sheet, which I did already use on the set, and then we also get two unnumbered bags to build the overall set. Like on all the other 2019 LEGO instructions, we have the ability to get the instructions off the LEGO Life app right there on the corner by scanning that QR code. We have the back of the instructions with the Win Robot. We flip open once, we have the piece count for two pages right there. And then we flip open one more time, you can get the instructions off the LEGO Life app. And then this little set does connect to one of the bigger sets inside the LEGO Overwatch theme, which is that other big ship. Both of them can connect to form one big ship. I guess it's just very nice. If you want to get both the sets, then you can connect them, and it's pretty nice. They both come with this sort of like launch pad like thingy right there. I don't know a lot about Overwatch, just another little thing, so if you're watching this video or my other video, I don't know a lot about Overwatch, but here is the final model for the set, so let's take a look and see what that looks like. Okay, so here is the final overall model. We do get some nice extra pieces down here, so for our extra pieces, we get one of those neck bracket pieces right there in white, which is used on Tracer. We also get one of those stick pieces with the side stud right there on the side, which is used on Widowmaker's gun. We also get a lightsaber handle piece in black as well for Widowmaker's gun. We get some 1x1 tile pieces, one light gray curved and one light gray circular, and then one translucent blue circular. We get some regular studs. We get one in light gray with the hole in the center, one in black with the hole in the center, and then we have a translucent blue one. And then finally, we get one of those little hockey pieces right there in red. So those are all of our extra pieces, bringing us back to our final model. So let's take a look at those minifigures. Starting off with our first minifigure, we get Tracer. She comes with two accessories right there, two white guns, which also have some of those translucent blue tile pieces circular right there on the sides. We also have some regular light gray studs right there with the holes in the center just for the guns. Those are pretty cool. Really love that new gun mold that we get inside the Overwatch sets. This set also includes a black version of that same piece for Widowmaker, and then inside the D.Va set we get one in pink for her character. That's also pretty nice to know. So yeah, those are the guns. Another thing with Tracer is that she has this neck accessory, this neck bracket right here, which also attaches to a light gray stud with the hole in the center with one of these lightning bolt pieces in blue, since that's her dash attack, as I've been told, since I don't know a lot about Overwatch. That's just what happens, I guess. That's one of her powers, since she fights stuff, I guess, you know? So it's Tracer. And then she also has some yellowish-orange legs right there, which also have a little bit of printing on them. Sort of like a weird pattern right there, which also continues right there to her torso, which is in a dark tan-like color right there, which we have the printing on the front. She also has some dark gray hands. We get some printing on the back, so we can take off her head and remove that under the neck accessory a little bit right there. And then we have some more printing right there on the back. That's the back of the torso. And then you can put back on this neck bracket. And then we have the lightning bolt piece, which we can insert right back there. And then we have her head, which we can plop right back on. She does have two facial expressions, the first one being this facial expression, and then we can remove her hairpiece and turn around her head, and then we have this other facial expression right there. That is her other facial expression. She's smiling in both of them, which is pretty nice. And then also she comes with a newly molded hairpiece, which is also pretty cool to get, since I actually really like that hairpiece. It's in a nice dark brown and not inside a weird, wacky color like some of the other hair pieces that we got inside this theme, but, I mean, pretty nice. So yeah, that's all for Tracer. The second minifigure that we get inside the set is Widowmaker. She comes with two accessories, one being this little grappling piece right here, and then the other one being this rather large gun, which I actually think that looks really cool. I really like how LEGO designed that. It just looks very nice. I like how it looks. We also have a nice little scope right there at the top. Two handles right there. Very nice gun. Really like how that was made. Also, just right there. It's just very nice, the different colors that they used. As for her minifigure, she has some very nice dark grayish legs right there, which she also has a pink hips piece, which we have printing on both of them, continuing to her pink torso piece right there, which we have some nice printing right there on the front. She also has some printing on the back, so you can just move her hair a little bit. You can see the printing on the back. She has some purple arms and some dark gray hands. She has two facial expressions, the first one being this not-so-happy one. And then you can remove her hairpiece, you can spin her head around, and then she's a lot more happier in that one, giving us a nice little wink. She also comes with a newly molded hairpiece as well, just like Tracer. Very nice hairpiece. But it's in a weird purple color and also has this thing right there on the front of it. But pretty much both of these characters are very accurate compared to their actual forms inside the video game. But yeah, that's pretty much all for Widowmaker. Okay, so here is all of the other builds that are included within the set. We do get this first little small build with Tracer, which is sort of like this weird like little energy thing right here, which I don't know why, but we got a cylinder translucent blue piece with this little plus printed on the front right there, which I guess it's like some sort of like energy thing, and then we have a stud underneath, and then a 1x1 tile piece, circular gray. So I don't know why that's included, but it's included. And then we get this overall very nice ship right here, which, I mean, at first when you look at the set, you see that there's a place to place your minifigure, but I guess you have to remove these 2x3 tile pieces in white. That clears a nice little spot for your character to sit. There is a control panel right there, which you can see we have a nice printed piece right there. Really love that that's a printed piece. We only get so many printed pieces inside this set, which most of them are on the minifigures, but that piece is just printed. You can sit your Tracer down into the ship. Can't have them leaning backwards, you just have to have them sitting up inside the ship. We also get this little platform, I guess, on this large dish piece, which we also get a 2x2 circular brick right there in TransClear, which this has a WP-G, which is a drone charging station, I guess, since this is a drone? I don't know why, but it's a drone. And then this goes right there on the bottom to keep this up like it's levitating. Really like that. Wish that was actually clear. That would have been a whole lot better if that was a clear piece. But then right away you can see a lot of the stickers that are used on the set. There are a lot of nice building techniques though. Like I do really like these engines on the back, how they are connected, and also right here in the front, how that looks. That just looks really nice. Which you can definitely see a lot of the stickers. We have one on this 2x4 slope piece right here, which you can see a little bit of it. A little bit of it is covered by this piece, which also has a sticker on it. We have this sticker right here, which has Satellite Drone XR9, which I guess that's what this is. This is a Satellite Drone XR9. We have the same text right there on this sticker, and then the same sticker just reversed. And then we have another sticker right here, which has the no step and then a Overwatch symbol on this 1x3 tile as well. We have another one of those on this side. And then we have the last of the stickers right here on these pieces. Really love these wing pieces, also used inside that A-Wing that I reviewed. If you haven't seen that, link in the description below or card above. We also have the same sticker usage right there. Pretty much overall very nice. Love the engines. We also get this little container, I guess, which you can pop open, and then you can put this little thing inside there. I guess that's just to store it if you so want to. And then you have that as your extra accessory. And then these pieces, I guess you could just leave off to the side if you're using it as a ship. If not, you can just remove your minifigure. You can put these plate pieces back right on top of here. And then you gotta make sure that this is stuck on tight, which I guess that likes to fall off very easily. And then you have a very nice ship and some nice minifigures to go along with it. So yeah, that's pretty much all for this video. Remember to like and subscribe and hit that bell icon so every time I upload a new video. So yeah, that's it for now, and I will see you next time. Bye!